श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। श्री सत्य विजयाम्बोधे जातम सत्य प्रियामृतम जरामृति जंघनी तु विबुधानामुदे सदा विद्यापीठ विधातारं विद्यावारिधि चंदिरं विद्यार्थि वत्सलं वंदे महामहिम सद्गुरुं। श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। श्री सत्यप्रिय तीर्थ स्वामी जी वॉज एन इंडियन हिंदू फिलोसोफर, अ गुरु, अ स्कॉलर एंड द पॉन्टिफ ऑफ उत्तराधिमठ परंपरा। He was a successor to Sri Satyavijaya Tirtha Swamiji. Satyapriya Tirtha was born as Garlapa Dramacharya in Raichur. He was initially given ashrama by Sri Satyapurna Tirtha and named as Sri Satyavarya Tirtha. Satyavarya Tirtha, as per orders of his guru, went on to his tour for Tirtha Yatre and propagation of Madhva philosophy. At the same time, on the other hand, here, Satyapurna Tirtha Swamiji fell ill and sensed his end to be near. Satyapurna Tirtha Swamiji called for Sri Satyavarya Tirtha, but due to lack of proper communication and transport facilities that time, Satyapurna Tirtha gave ashrama to Sri Satyavijaya Tirtha and ordered to give the next ashrama to Sri Satyavarya Tirtha Swamiji only. Later, Satyavarya Tirtha Swamiji came to know about his guru's travel to the lotus feet of Lord. Satyavarya Tirtha felt immense grief. Though Satyavarya Tirtha was eldest among him and Satyavijaya Tirtha, but Satyavijaya Tirtha was the ashrama guru. Hence, respecting his guru's decision, he again went to continue his tour. Here, on the other side, Satyavijaya Tirtha ruled the mutt for 11 long years with immense glory. And one who took his name, victory was sure for him. The name itself indicates Vijaya, meaning victory. Satyavijaya Tirtha, once when he visited Arni, today what we call it as Satyavijaya Nagara, he sensed his end to be near. But Satyavarya Tirtha couldn't attend on time. Hence, Satyavijaya Tirtha packed the idols of Lord Rama and Goddess Sita Devi and placed them in a treasure box and locked them in a room in the house of Arani Maharaja. He gave the keys of that room to Maharaja and asked to give the keys only to Sri Satyavarya Tirtha. Satyavijaya Tirtha ordered the king and other pandits to offer Gandha, Tulsi, Naivedya to the Lord daily by putting all of them in front of the room. The king and the pandits followed the orders of Satyavijaya Tirtha and this went on for few days together. When Satyavarya Tirtha Swamiji came to know all of this, he repented a lot for his absence during his guru's last times. He immediately left for Arani and directly went to the king's house. The king, as the orders of Satyavijaya Tirtha Swamiji, gave the key to Sri Satyavarya Tirtha. Satyavarya Tirtha Swamiji tried to open the lock and have darshan of Lord Rama and Sita. But the key didn't open at all. Even after repeated attempts by everyone, the key didn't open. Satyavarya Tirtha later understood his mistake. He immediately went to the Vrindavan of Satyavijaya Tirtha. It is always said that one must first bestow himself in front of his guru. We all know the composition, Guruvina Gulama Naguva Tanaka. Dorayadanna Mukuti. Unless you surrender yourself to your guru, you won't achieve salvation, you won't achieve mukti. Then Satyavijaya Tirtha appeared before himself in astral form and named him as Satyapriya Tirtha and made him successor to Uttaradhimath. Since then, Satyapriya Tirtha never turned back. He was a saint of very high order with mystic powers. Satyapriya Tirtha Swamiji performed a number of miracles. Once, he brought a boy who was completely believed to be dead back to life by Satyapriya Tirtha. The joy of the boy's parents knew no bounds. They fell at the feet of Swamiji and prayed for his anugraha. Similarly, Sri Satyapriya Tirtha once visited Melkote Sri Yoga Narasimha Swami temple. He was late and the temple door was closed. Sri Satyapriya Tirtha stood in front of the main door and poured out his heart in praise of Lord Sri Narasimha and gently touched the door. To the surprise of all, the door opened of its own accord. The bells rang and Mangalarti was being performed to the Moola deity. With tears of joy rolling down his cheeks, he had the darshan of Yoga Narasimha Swami. There was a great kavi called Ghanashyam. He He was a very reputed poet in North India by the name Ghanashyam Kavi. He had written more than 100 dramas in Sanskrit till then. He was also considered an authority in Advaita Vedanta and Sahitya literature as well. He was an eyewitness to the vast learning of Sri Satyapriya Tirtha, of his humility, majesty and power of expression in highlighting the truth hidden in various Vedic texts. Hearing the unbiased and highly thoughtful words of Sri Satyapriya Tirtha, the said poet Ghanashyam Kavi, being a very impartial scholar, offered himself as a devotee to Lord Rama and Swamiji and received Mudra Dharana from Swamiji. Ghanashyam also wrote a drama Prachanda Rahudayam in 5 chapters in which Sri Satyapriya Tirtha has been shown as the hero. He was the main protagonist in the work. In this work, the doctrines of Advaita, Dvaita and other schools of thought have been discussed and finally the victory embraces the hero Sri Satyapriya Tirtha Swamiji. Sri Satyapriya Tirtha Swamiji's glory was known countrywide. It was customary in those days at Kashi to erect a pillar as a symbol denoting the glory, the victory, inscribing the details of victory on such pillars. Such pillar, the Jayasthamba, was erected establishing the victory of Sri Satyapriya Tirtha Swamiji that times. Not only these miracles, he was also known greatly for giving boon to those couples who had no issues since many years. Even today, if we pray, if we chant Satyapriya Stotra, it is sure that you would get Santana Prapti. Satyapriya Tirtha Swamiji is known for giving boon to various issueless couples. Not just the miracles, he even composed many works. Some of his important works are Commentary on Mahabhashya, Commentary on Mandukya Upanishad, Commentary on Atharvana Upanishad, and his magnum opus Jaitirtha Stuti in praise of Jaitirtha Swamiji. We all know that it is customary to reverentially touch the feet of Lord for one who is born on this earth. Just in 7 small years, he left an unerasable and unforgettable mark in the Madhva philosophy. He gave ashrama to Sri Satyabodh Tirtha Swamiji and left his mortal remains at Mana Madurai on Chaitra Shuddha Trayodashi. Today, on his auspicious day, let us all follow the path led by Sri Satyapriya Tirtha Swamiji and stick to our Madhva philosophy. Shri Krishna Arpanamastu.